Let your escort lion-hearted be summoned to receive a general's blessing ere they depart upon their dread adventure.
Dear sir, they come.
Is still
tarantara, tarantara.
The uncomfortable feel,
tarantara.
And we find the wisest thing,
tarantara, tarantara.
Is to slap her chest and sing
tarantara.
For when threatened with the mute,
tarantara, tarantara.
And your heart is in your boots,
tarantara.
There is nothing brings it round like the trumpet's martial sound, like the trumpet's martial sound.
Tarantara, 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 tarantara.
To cheer, who are going to meet their fate in a highly nervous state. Still, to us is evident these attentions are well meant. Observe to greater stress on the risks that on us press, and of reference elect to our chance of coming back. Still, perhaps it would be wise not to carp or criticize, for it's very evident these attentions are well meant.
Yes, it's very evident these attentions are well meant. Evident, yes, well meant. Evident,
ah, yes, well meant.
Don't the repeated acts of theft and pillage, which are the sense of duty's vindication, I, circumstance's victim, have been guilty.
Young Frederic,
who calls
your late commander,
and I, your little Ruth.
Oh, mad intruders, how dare ye face me? Know ye not, O rash ones, that I have doomed you to extermination?
Have mercy on us. Hear us ere you slaughter.
I do not think I ought to listen to you, yet mercy should annoy us turn resentment. And so, say on.
When you had left the pilot fold, we tried to raise our spirits fit, according to our custom, all with whip and quip of weight. But all in vain the quips we heard. We lay and sobbed upon the rocks, until to somebody occurred a startling paradox.
A paradox!
A paradox, a most ingenious paradox. We quips and quibbles hard in flux, but none to fit this paradox.
A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox. A paradox! Taste for curious quips or cranks in contradiction square, and with the laughter on our lips we wished you there to hear. We said if we could tell it him, how Frederick would the joke enjoy. And so we risked both life and limb to tell it to our boy.
That paradox,
that most ingenious paradox, we quips and quibbles heard in flocks, but none to reach that paradox.
A paradox, a most ingenious paradox.
For some ridiculous reason, which however I've no desire to be disloyal, some person in authority, I don't know who, very likely the astronomer royal, has decided that, although for such a beastly month as February, 28 days as a rule are plenty, 1 year in every 4, his days shall be reckoned as 29. Through some singular coincidence, I shouldn't be surprised if it were owing to the agency of an ill-natured fairy. You are the victim of this clumsy arrangement, having been born in leap year on the 29th of February. And so, by a simple arithmetical process, you'll easily discover that though you've lived 21 years, yet if we go by birthdays, you're only 5 and a little bit over.
Dear me, let's see. Yes, yes, with yours my figures do agree. How quaint the ways of paradox. At common sense she gaily mocks. Though counting in the usual way, years 21 I've been alive. Yet reckoning by my natal day, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I am a little boy of 5.
He is a little boy of 5.
A paradox, a most ingenious paradox.
A curious paradox.
A most ingenious paradox.
I've locked itself in door, away, away.
Away, away, and I expire. I find my duty hard to do today. My heart is filled with anguish dire. It strikes me to the core, away, away.
With force and power he tricked us of our right. Then vengeance how the pirates all decide. Our nature stern he softened with his lies, and in return tonight the traitor dies.
Yes, yes, tonight the traitor dies.
Yes, yes, tonight the traitor dies.
Tonight he dies.
Yes, or early tomorrow.
His girls like wives.
They were wealth and sorrow.
The ones of sport.
In the natures they cherish.
And all who plot.
To abuse it and perish.
Tonight he dies, just for early tomorrow. His girls like wives, they were wealth and sorrow. The ones of sport in the natures they cherish. And all who plot to abuse it and perish. Away, away, away.
Disclosure has just been made. Mabel, my dearly loved one, I bound myself to serve the pirate captain until I reached my 120th birthday.
But you are 21.
I've just discovered that I was born in leap year. And that birthday will not be reached by me till 1940.
Oh, horrible catastrophe appalling.
And so,
thank you.
in 1940 I of age shall be. I'll then return and claim you, I declare it.
It seems so long.
Swear that till then you will be true to me.
Yes, I'll be strong. My old Stanley's dead and gone, I swear it.
For here is love, and here is true, and here is good for joy as love. She will be faithful to her soul, till we are wedded in our love.
For here is love, and here is true.
Oh, here is love, and here is true.
She will be faithful to her soul,
till we are
wed and even after.
Till we are wed
and even after.
Yes, even after.
Oh, here is love, and here is true, and here is good for joyous laughter. She will be faithful to her soul,
till we are wed and even after.
She will be faithful to her soul, till we are wed and even after.
That's behind.
Rentala.
Yet when the danger's near,
rentala, rentala.
He managed to appear,
rentala.
As insensible to fear as anybody here, as anybody here.
Rentala, rentala, rentala.
Sergeant, approach. Young Frederic was to have led you to death and glory.
That is not a pleasant way of putting it.
No matter, he will not so lead you, for he has allied himself once more with his old associates.
He has acted shamefully.
You speak falsely. You know nothing about it. He has acted nobly.
He has acted nobly.
Dearly as I loved him before, his heroic sacrifice to his sense of duty has endeared him to me tenfold. He has done his duty. I will do mine. Go ye and do yours.
Right, oh.
This is perplexing.
We cannot understand it at all.
Still, as he is actuated by a sense of duty,
that makes a difference, of course. At the same time, we repeat, we cannot understand it at all.
No matter, our course is clear. We must do our best to capture these pirates alone. It is most distressing to us to be the agents whereby our erring fellow creatures are deprived of that liberty which is so dear to all. But we should have thought of that before we joined the force.
We should.
It's too late now.
It is.
Well, when a felon's not engaged in his employment, or maturing his felonious little plans, his capacity for innocent enjoyment, is just as great as any honest man's. Our feelings we with difficulty smother, when constabulary duties to be done, take one consideration with another. A policeman's lot is not a happy one.
Oh, when constabulary duties to be done, a policeman's lot is not a happy one.
Enterprising burglar's not a burgling, when the cutthroat isn't occupied in crime. He loves to hear the little brook a-gurgling, and listen to the merry village chime. When the coster's finished jumping on his mother, he loves to lie a-basking in the sun. I'll take one consideration with another. A policeman's lot is not a nappy one.
Oh, when constabulary duties to be done, a policeman's lot is not a happy one.
Hush, hush, I hear them on the manor approaching. With stealthy steps the pirates are approaching. Come in force with stealthy stride. Our obvious course is now to hide.
Speak a word, the flies foot on the beat of steel.
a word. I see a light inside. The Major General comes, so quickly hide.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes. Tormented with the anguished dread of falsehood unatoned, I lay upon my sleepless bed and tossed and turned and groaned. The man who finds his conscience ache, no peace at all enjoys. And as I lay in bed awake, I thought I heard a noise.
He thought he heard a noise.
Aha!
No, all is still in dale on hill. My mind is set at ease, so still the scene it must have been, the sighing of the
Thank you.
dwelt upon our feelings. Revenge is sweet and flavors all our dealings. With courage rare and resolution manly, for death prepare unhappy General Stanley.
Is he to die unshriven, unannealed?
Advantage you've contrived, but your proud triumph will not be long-lived. Don't say you're orphans, for we know that game. On your allegiance we've a stronger claim. We charge you yield. We charge you yield in Queen Victoria's name.
Place them at the bar.
One moment. Let me tell you who they are. They are no members of the common throne. They are all noble men who have gone wrong.
They are all noble men who have gone wrong.
Englishmen unmoved that statement hears, because with all our faults we love our House of Peers. I pray you pardon me, expired king. Peers will be peers and youth will have its fling. Resume your ex and legislative duties and take my daughters, all of whom are beauties.